Okay guys, you've finished your internal pack up. There's one more step. As you step out of the door, we need to close this isolator here. Remember when we were first setting it up, this was the one we had to open? We close it again now to isolate the annex from the main tent from the outside. As you step down, we zip up the door, the canvas, and the fly screen. Stepping down the stairs as you go. We remove the Velcro tabs from the door, remove these one tab at a time, and leave them stuck to the back of the door. Same on the other side, remove the Velcro tabs, one tab at a time, leaving them stuck to the back of the door. Your door folds inside, and we're going to fold up the stairs. Lift your door, fold your stairs away, and close it up. Grab your keys again, remembering the big key is the one for the door, and twist it clockwise as far as it goes. You will see and feel the door pull in tight. Give it a bit of a tug to ensure. Close your back claps, and we're ready to go around the back and remove the air valves. Okay, around the back here, guys, we're gonna undo the five air valves. We'll start by taking the elastic strap off, unzip the two, and then under here, we're gonna unscrew the air valves. The whole main tent is gonna come down. Very easy process. One air valve in the middle. Two on the other end. Once we unscrew these air valves, we're going to tuck the canvas back into the trailer nice and neat. Undo the elastic strap, and we're going to tuck the canvas away. Grab it by your little canvas loop, pull towards you, and push the canvas inside the camper. Continue this process all the way along until it's neatly packed away. Extremely important to ensure you only hold it by the canvas tab, not any of the other strap. Lifting, tucking, and we're done on this side. We're ready to go around the front and put the annex in. As you come back around the front, unclip your annex on both sides. This is going to make sure that we can push the annex far enough across into the trailer. We slide back underneath. You lift your air poles and you push them as far across as you can into the trailer. You'll see the canvas go nice and taut as everything sits inside. What we've got here now is at least the first third of the annex inside. It's going to make your pack up so much easier. We come around and we're going to take out the seven air valves out of the front of the annex. Like we always say, guys, this thing goes down quicker than it goes up, which also means if the weather turns bad and you want to get out of there, you can. You're done. Right, all seven air valves are out. Grab your legs and we're going to lift these up and we're going to sit them towards the middle of the camper trailer to form a triangle. Center leg into the center. We're not throwing them a long way in, we're just sitting them inside the edge. We're just looking to get that nice canvas line across the front. We come down this end, grab it by the guy rope strap and pull out and walk out in an arc. You'll see the top of the canvas starts to go flat. That's what we're looking for. As we come around the front, we're also gonna grab this bunch. We're gonna sit it across the trailer so we get a nice straight line across here. And then we're gonna sit that up on the edge. We're not looking to throw it in the trailer, we're just looking to get it sitting up nice and neat. It's gonna be the same on this side. We walk out in an arc, watching the canvas up the top, making sure it goes flat. We're not pulling hard. Again, grab your bunch here. pull it across so that it's nice and flat, and sit this up on the edge of the camper. What we've effectively done here is we've moved as much of the bulk away from the hinges as we can. Now, this bit you can do on your own. It's a lot easier if you employ a mate. Hey buddy, can you give me a hand? If you reach underneath this canvas, right underneath, you'll see where the main bunch is. If you can put one hand there and one hand there, as we flip this up, I'm gonna get you to follow this up with your hand, please. And we'll get a nice, neat flat. On three, one, two, three. And there we have it, guys. Most of your annex is in. We're gonna go around the other side. We're just gonna ensure that it's neat and flat and everything's compacted into the middle. Then we're gonna close the rest of the camper up. So around this side, we pull this across the top. The important step is lift it up and ensure that any bunch underneath hasn't moved close to the hinge. Pull it back across to the middle. Again, pull this across. If you see the bunch has moved to the hinge, pull it back into the center of the camper trailer. You see there, it all sits nice and flat already below the line of the camper. So, it's the reverse procedure. Your back bed lid is gonna close first. Undo your two bed corners, so loosen the straps and flip the corners off. Undo your elastic strap from the middle. And take the two poles out. This is very important. The bed's gonna do what it wants to do. Don't touch the bed. One hand lightly on the bottom of the pole. Remove the pin and lower the pole gently onto the spare wheel. Your pin goes straight back through the hole. Same procedure for the other side. Remove the pin, holding the pole gently, lower it down onto the spare wheel. Your bed is gonna walk it up to just past 90 degrees. You'll find a nice balance point. You're not gonna have to hold it as much. What we're gonna do here is a nice critical step. We're gonna clear the canvas away from the hinge. If you push your arm up inside the hole you've created and push the canvas forward and off the box. If you found that balance point, bed will stay there. If not, just slowly walk around the other side. Pushing the canvas again away and into the hole and flattening out the canvas at the back. Then we just let our bed lid drop. The next step from here that's gonna make your life really, really easy, you will see a bunch here that we just created. If you reach inside, grab this bunch, pull it towards you and push it down, you will see that that bed lid drops again. We're gonna do the same on the other side. Grab the bunch, pull it forward and pull it down. We put our spare wheel away at the back at this stage so that we don't forget. If there's two of you, you can both push the bed lid down on each side, tucking the canvas away as you go. If there's only one of you, the trick that will make your life easy is get your J-clip, screw it out as far as you can, and then we're gonna lower the bed lid down. To lower the bed lid down when you're on your own, the easiest one is take your armpit, drive it into the corner of the camper, standing on tippy toes, and just drop your body weight. The reason we've lengthened that out is that's now gonna give me a chance to go around the other side and tuck the canvas away nice and neatly. Ensure your canvas is always tucked inside your camper. Anywhere canvas sticks out is going to be water or possible dust. Again, armpit into the corner of the bed lid and down you come. Closing the latches on this side as we go. We come back around the other side. We're gonna close the back latch up and readjust the front one down. So just screw it back in. I like to call these rule of thumb. If you can't push it down with one thumb, it's too tight. Loosen it off. That's perfect. You don't want too tight, you don't want too loose. You just want nice, neat seal on that bed lid. Your front bed is exactly the same. Remove your bed corners. Undo your over center latch in the middle and remove the elastic. It's very important the orientation of this pin when you put it back through. It has to come all the way through the middle to hold everything together. To make your life easier, get your elastic loop, tuck it inside the canvas so that you don't have to try and reach it in the middle of the camper. And then the same again. This bed lid is going to come up to just past 90 degrees and we're going to clear the canvas away from the hinge and flatten out the canvas at the back. And we're going to do the same again around the other side. As I said, if you can find that balance point, that's going to make your life extremely easy. Lowering the bed lid down, and again, just moving that bunch away from the bulk. Tucking your canvas in as you go, and again, moving the bunch forward and down. You will naturally see the bed lid drop. As we come down, same story again. If you're on your own, loosen out your clip. It's going to give you the best chance of tucking that canvas on the other side. Karate chop sweep through there. Tuck all your canvas away and armpit into the bed lid. Drop your weight and hook up. Back around the other side again. We're going to tuck that canvas away and seal that bed lid down completely. Again, guys, take a couple of seconds to ensure along the front line you have also cleared the canvas away. Armpit into the corner of the bed, dropping your weight, and we do up the clip. While you're around this side of the camper, take the weight of the roof rack by pulling down and remove the two pins. We can lower the roof rack back across the top of the camper. Coming back around the front, we will readjust this J-clip. And we'll latch it down, remembering your rule of thumb. Grab your roof cage, lowering it down, and clipping it into position. One step that's going to save you a lot of heartache. This roof cage feels like it clipped down tight. You don't want to put 100 kilos or plus of weight on this roof cage and have those bump stops compress. Just double check it is tight, get your body weight and drop it down and ensure that these clips are going to stay clipped into position. Your pins come back through and are latched off. That's your entire camper packed away. We ensure all our switches that we don't need are off. Close your switch box and you're done. Thanks, guys. I hope that was informative and it makes your next camping trip all the more enjoyable.